Half-a-day students, I am Governor Lou Leon Guerrero. You all have been through a year of big changes. We've had to adapt and make big changes to keep our families and our island safe. But with change comes opportunity and a chance to try new things like PBS University. While Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenorio and I will continue to do our part to keep our island safe, you students have a part to play as well. Your part is to keep learning and to keep up with your lessons. That's why I am happy to see you here ready to learn with PBS University. PBS University is a way to bring a continuous educational curriculum to you while you stay safe at home during this time. To help you keep up with your studies, we asked our friends at PBS Guam and the Guam Department of Education to put together this episode. Thank you for doing your part and have a great lesson.
PBS University is a program by PBS Guam and the Guam Department of Education in conjunction with public school teachers. These lessons are created to provide both parents and students with a unique educational experience while helping students to continue learning at home. PBS University, next on PBS Guam.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Come along, let's sing a song. We'll have a great adventure.
Today's the day, let's learn and play.
We'll have a great adventure.
Numbers,
letters,
science things, all that we can do. Help you deal with how you feel. Share with us too.
It's super cool and just like school.
Our awesome learning adventures. So grab a friend, the fun will end. Our awesome learning adventures. Learning adventures with PBS University.
Hi, boys and girls, Casalelia. That's how you say hello in Pohnpei. My name is Mrs. De Guzman, and I'm one of the kindergarten teachers for PBS University Guam. I focus on literacy, which is anything dealing with reading, writing, speaking, and listening. Every time we meet, I like to call our time together circle time. On our last episode, we featured the letters A and B. We practiced writing our letters, saying the sounds, and thought of some things that began with the letters A and B. Today, we're going to learn about the letters C and D. We will learn how to write the letters, learn the sounds, and you're going to help me think of some things that begin with the letter C and the letter D. Let's make that an I can statement. I can identify, write, and say the sounds for the letters C and D. Let's get to it. It's time for circle time. This is the letter C. We know that every letter has an uppercase and a lowercase letter. Sometimes people say capital letter or big letter, and little letter. The sound for the letter C is a quick sound. K. Can you say that with me? K. Awesome job. Can you help me think of some things that begin with the letter C?
Cow.
Cow.
Cat.
Can.
Cat.
Cat. What do scissors do?
Cut.
Cut, that's right. All those things start with the letter C. Now, whenever I write my letters, I like to say a little rhyme to help me. For the uppercase C, the rhyme goes like this. It's easy to make a C, you see, like a smile big and wide, turned on its side. Can you try writing the uppercase C and saying the rhyme with me? Let's try it. It's easy to make a C, you see, like a smile big and wide turned on its side. Awesome! For the lowercase C, the rhyme goes like this. Cool cars go down curvy C. Stop on your way up. That's the key. Let's try writing our lowercase C with the rhyme. Cool cars go down curvy C. Stop on the way up. That's the key. Cool. The more you practice your letters, the better and more comfortable you'll become. Here's our next featured letter, the letter D. This is the uppercase D and lowercase D. The sound for D is also a quick sound. Duh. Can you say that with me?
Duh.
Great job. Now, let's think of some things that begin with the letter D.
Desk.
Desk.
Dog.
Dog. What is she? She's digging. That's right.
And doll.
Doll. All those things begin with the letter D. Now let's listen to the rhyme we say when we practice our uppercase D. Straight line to the ground, then take a break. Half circle around is what you'll make. Try that with me. You can practice writing the uppercase D in the air, or if you have a notebook, paper, and pencil, go ahead and use that. Straight line to the ground, then take a break. Half circle around is what you'll make. Awesome job! Here's how we write the lowercase D. Circle around to the left, like a shiny new dime. Then straight line down, and it takes no time. Let's try writing the lowercase D. Circle around to the left, like a shiny new dime. Then a straight line down, and it takes no time. You are excellent writers. I asked some of our friends to show us how they write their letters. Let's check them out. I loved seeing our friends practice writing their letters. Sometimes you need someone to help you, and that's okay. Keep practicing. Thank you for spending some time with me today, and I'm always looking forward to seeing you again for Circle Time with Mrs. D. Guzman. I'd love to hear from you. Have an adult like your mom, dad, an older brother or sister help you if you'd like to email me. You can email me just to say hi or share what you enjoyed during Circle Time today. Stay safe. Have an amazing day.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Half a day, everybody, and welcome back to PBS University. My name is Mr. Kendasa, for those of you just joining us, and we had so much fun last week. We're going to do it again this week, right? Awesome. That is wonderful to hear. This week, we're going to try a new I can statement. You ready to hear it? Repeat after me.
I can identify numbers 1 to 10.
So why is it important to identify numbers? There's so many reasons, right? So we see numbers all around us. One of them can be to find where you live, right? What if you're driving through a street and you can't identify numbers? You might go to the wrong house. Oh my goodness. So by identifying numbers, you're gonna know exactly where you live, right? 1, 2, 3, your amazing street. I wanna live there. What's another reason of why it's important to identify numbers? Yeah, we can tell how many things we have or how many things we need, right? It's important to identify these. And it's not just in the way we write a number, right? It's also in the way we have things or objects. all around us. Like, look at these birds. How many birds do you see? Let's count them. We have 1, 2, 3 birds. That's 3. There's so many different ways to represent that number or to show that number. So let's look at numbers in the way we write them and in the way we see them as in objects, like these birds.
Here's the number 1 and 1 triangle. Number 2 and 2 squares. 3 and 3 diamonds. 4 and 4 circles. 5 and 5 stars. You're a star. 6 and 6 polygons. 7 and 7 ovals. 8 and 8 triangles. 9 and 9 squares. 10 and 10 diamonds.
Wonderful! So, I was outside a little earlier and I saw what a beautiful day it was. Do you like to look at clouds and try to find a shape or an animal that you can see? Let's go outside and see if we can find clouds that look like the numbers we just talked about, and we'll see if you can identify them. Does that sound like a good idea? Alright, let's go!
Let's see if we can spot some clouds that look like numbers. Ooh! What number does that look like? Yeah, the number 1. Can we see another one? Oh, what number does this look like? 8. You're right. Is there another cloud that looks like a number? Which one does this look like? 10. Yeah, very good. Ooh, what does this cloud look like? What number? 6. Yes, that's the one. 6. Bye, 6.
Wasn't it so cool to do that together? So let's go outside again and we'll see if we can find the shape of an animal, and maybe you'll see your favorite one. And we'll identify what number it is by counting how many there are, right? Alright, let's go!
Ooh, what animal does that cloud look like? A bunny rabbit, right? We have 1, 2, 3, and 4 bunny rabbits. So that's a group of 4 rabbits, and that represents the number 4. Ooh, I see one. What animal does that cloud look like? An elephant, yup. So we have 1, 2, and 3 elephants. So we have a group of 3 elephants. That represents the number 3. I see a cloud with a long neck. Could it be a giraffe? That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 9 giraffes. That's the number 9. And we even have a little baby giraffe, huh? Ooh, what could this cloud be? A fish. Yeah, we have 1 fish. 2 little fishies. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 little fishies. A school of fish. That's the number 7. Yeah. Whoa. Is that a unicorn? That's 1 unicorn. and two unicorns. So we have two unicorns, and that's the number two.
So now that you can identify the numbers 1 through 10, let's see our I can statement again. I can identify numbers 1 to 10. Come back next week so we can learn even more math skills. And remember, math counts because you count. See you later. Bye.
Hey, boys and girls, that means hello in CHamoru. Welcome back to PBS University. I'm your kindergarten science teacher, Miss L. Today, we're going to talk about feelings and emotions. That's right, feelings and emotions. Do you know how you feel on the inside? We're going to talk about them and do something really fun today through science. So let's say our I can statement first, so we can understand what we're learning. Ready? Okay. I can express my feelings and emotions in positive ways. Say it one more time. I can express my feelings and emotions in positive ways. Very good, boys and girls. Let's get started. I just want to show you a couple things that we can do to positively show and conquer our negative feelings and turn them into positive ones.
Well, sometimes you can feel angry.
But here's a way that can help us calm down and think about why we're upset, and it'll pass, I promise. So do what Miss L does. We're gonna count backwards to help us calm down. So anytime you're feeling angry or upset, I want you to stop and think and count. Ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Don't you feel better already?
And other times, you can feel so silly. What about sad?
If you're feeling sad, here's another thing you can do to help you turn that frown upside down. So boys and girls, I want you to try and talk and communicate with people you trust. Who are some people you trust? Your mom, your dad, your favorite teacher, like me, or even a best friend. You can talk to them so they can help you solve what's bothering you, help you talk it through. Yeah. So when you talk about your feelings, sometimes that'll make you feel better.
Who's ready to get happy? I know I am. So let's start our science experiment and make slime. Safety first, boys and girls. So what I'm gonna need you to do is make sure you get permission from your parents and help to get all the materials and put it together.
Here's some materials and ingredients that you'll need in order to make the slime.
First, you'll need 6 ounces of white school glue. Then you'll need some bowls for mixing and maybe some extras so you can store for later. Then you'll need 1 tablespoon of contact solution or eye solution. Then you'll need 1 tablespoon of baking soda. And then some food coloring. 4 colors will do fine.
Joining us today is my nephew and nieces, Jaikai, Nala, and Lei.
So what do you guys know about feelings and emotions?
Feelings, panic, happy.
Happy, sad. What else?
Sad, happy.
Weird.
Weird?
Fishy.
Okay. What else do you know about feelings? What do you guys think about mixing feelings? Do you think you could feel things more than one feeling at the same time?
Yes.
Like, what kind of feelings can you feel at the same time?
Like, you can feel happy. Sad and happy at the same time.
Grumpy and sad.
An example, what would make you happy?
If it was our birthday, or if we could go to the water park, or if COVID was a good
Oh, very good. Yeah. What about sad? What would make you feel sad?
Staying home all day, sitting in our room.
Oh.
Without anything to do.
Oh yeah, man, what about angry? Have you ever felt angry? What about feeling angry at each other?
Yeah, I did it to Jake.
But is that how we show anger? How do you turn that anger into something positive? Do you guys know how to change that feeling of anger into something positive? So this is what you do. If you feel like you're getting very frustrated or angry at somebody, you can count backwards, because counting gets your brain to think about something else, and then it eventually gets you to calm down, okay? And then you breathe. Ready? So I want you guys to start at 10 and count backwards. Ready? Go.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Awesome sauce. Now it's time for the fun part. Now I'm gonna add all the ingredients together with my nephew and my nieces. So each of them has their own little bowl. They have chosen their own color to represent the feelings of sad, anger, and silliness, and they're gonna start mixing their own colors individually. Now the fun part, after you add your drops of food coloring, you get to mix it. You can use your hands or you can wear gloves. Look how they mix it, so much fun. So here are all our feelings, separate. We have anger, we have sadness, we have silliness, and we have happiness. Now, if all these feelings were to be combined, they would be mixed. Inside, when we feel, we can feel all these feelings. Sometimes they get mixed up. Sometimes they don't. But when it's all mixed up, it's okay, because we know it's what's inside of us, and there's always a way to try and get positive again.
Emotions are mixed up.
How fun was that, slime boys and girls? Did you feel excited? I know I did. I was feeling all kinds of happy and excited emotions at the same time. So if the slime can mix, our feelings can mix, but we can always learn how to show it positively. So let's say our I can statement one more time. Ready? I can express my feelings and emotions in positive ways. Did we do that today, boys and girls? I know I did. I know you did. Awesome job. Until next time, this was Miss L, your kindergarten science teacher. Bye.
Half a day students, welcome to PBS University. My name is John Fernandez, and I'm the superintendent of the Guam Department of Education. These PBS University lessons are made to help you to continue learning. The teachers here prepared fun lessons on science, character education, math, English, and more, and they made it for you, the students of Guam. We're very grateful to them for their instruction. We're also thankful for you students, parents, and guardians who are watching. Remember, stay safe and healthy, and we'll see you soon in the next school year. Thank you.
Half a day. And in Chukis, we say ranonym. I'm Mrs. Muth, your kindergarten social studies teacher. And this summer, boys and girls, we will be talking about community helpers right here on our beautiful island of Guam. And when we are done with these lessons, you will be able to do two things. One, you will be able to tell who community helpers are here on our island. And two, you will be able to tell how you can be a community helper. Are you ready to get started? Let's do this! Half a day and ranonym. Guess where I'm at? If you said at a school, you're absolutely correct. This week's lesson is on community helpers from within our Guam Department of Education. Are you ready to hear about them?
Here are the community helpers in Guam Department of Education. We have our superintendent, John Fernandez, and the three deputy superintendents, Joe Sanchez, Erica Cruz, and Dr. Ascension. They all work together with the community helpers at your school, boys and girls. We have the principals, the assistant principals, the teachers, the counselors, the school nurses, office staff, school aides, one-to-one aides, teacher assistants, cafeteria workers, and even the cleaners. They all work together to make sure everyone is safe, healthy, and that you, boys and girls, are all learning to be smarter. Now, let's listen to a school principal tell why she is a community helper, and we will also listen to some teachers sharing why they, too, are community helpers. Let's listen.
One less than half a day. My name is Maritess Garcia, principal of Finnegodson Elementary School. I am a community helper because I take care of a school. I make sure that a school is a safe and fun place to learn. I am a community helper because I work with teachers, school employees, and parents to help all students succeed. I believe that you, boys and girls, have the power to make our island of Guam and the rest of the world become a better place for the future. I am a community helper because I am a school principal. Thank you. Maraming salamat po. Kiniso kapur. Siduz maasi. Dana Dios.
Hi, I'm Mr. Molina. I'm a community helper because I help kids be the best that they can be.
Half a day. I'm Ms. Guerrero and I'm a community helper because I teach my kindergarten students to be expressive in their most creative way.
Half a day, I'm Ms. Patricio, and I am a community helper because I teach kindergarten students to believe in the power of themselves and their brains.
Half a day, hi, I'm Ms. H. I'm a community helper because I teach students to take care of themselves and our island.
Half a day, Guahu si Señor Esteban, Guahu yezodante comunidad, sa hu adzudad zan fanagu yezodanticia. Adios.
Half a day. I'm Mrs. Cruz. I'm a community helper, and I teach students to enjoy learning and believe that anything is possible.
Hi, my name is Lemetris Moore, or Mrs. Moore, and I am a community helper because I teach to help shape our students and the future, teaching future leaders.
Half a day. I'm Ms. Badajos, and I'm a community helper because I teach to help guide students to become responsible and educated people when they grow up. Have a wonderful day. Bye for now.
Well, you saw that there are a lot of community helpers within our Guam Department of Education. So, did you figure it out? Our Guam Department of Education community helpers love you, boys and girls. They want to make sure you're safe, that you're healthy, and that you continue to get smarter. So, when you see our superintendent, Mr. Fernandez, our principals, our teachers, school aides, teacher assistants, or even the people who clean the schools, please make sure you tell them, thank you for being a great community helper, and we love our schools. Guess what? You can be a community helper at home. How? Well, you can open the door for grandma or grandpa, or even your mom or dad if they need help. You can help pick up your toys and help clean up around the house. Or if there's garbage around your house, you can pick it up to keep your house clean. Remember, you too can be a community helper at your house. Stay safe.
Buenas and half a day. Mabuhay, rananim, konnichiwa, annyeonghaseyo, ni hao, aloha, and hello, boys and girls. My name is Mr. Navaretti, and welcome to PBS University Kindergarten Care to Education. In today's lesson, we will be learning about being responsible. Before we begin, let's read our I can statement together. Get ready. I can describe ways to be responsible at home, in school, and around our community. What does it mean to be responsible? Being responsible means that you are doing things that you are supposed to do and accepting the consequences of your actions. Can you think of ways to be responsible at home, in school, and around the community? Here are some examples of being responsible at home. Doing chores and completing them. Dusting, wiping, and sanitizing surfaces. Taking out the trash. Washing the dishes. Making your bed. Sweeping and mopping the floors. Vacuuming the carpet. Scrubbing the toilet if your parents allow you to. Folding or hanging your clothes. Helping your mommies and daddies wash and clean their car if they allow you to. Finishing your homework. And organizing your bookshelf. Here are some examples of being responsible in school.
Picking up your things and putting it in the proper area so nobody trips or falls is being responsible. It's always responsible to keep your mask on at all times so nobody spreads germs. Pushing in your chair, raising up your hand and waiting to be called to ask a question, to do whatever you need to, is being responsible. Also, cleaning up your mess, like wiping up the paint that you make on the tables. And if you're playing with toys, remember to clean up after yourself by picking them up and storing it in the proper area, so you can play with them again. Doing your work quietly and completing all of your assignments without any distractions is being responsible. When it is time to line up, remember to line up 6 feet apart away from your friends. Going down the stairs by holding onto the rails is being very responsible, as well as being safe. Staying away from broken equipment is being responsible. Remembering to tie your shoelace is also very responsible.
Be responsible!
Here are some examples of being responsible around the community. Wearing a face mask, social distancing by staying 6 feet apart from others, washing or sanitizing your hands, cleaning up your mess, wearing appropriate clothes and footwear out in public. Pop quiz! Your turn! Try to answer these questions correctly about being responsible. Shout yes if you think that it is a responsible thing to do, and shout no if you think it's not a responsible thing to do. Are you ready? Here we go! Number one, at home, you should always clean up your mess. Yes! Number two, at home, you should leave your clothes on the floor. No! Three, at home, you should take out the trash. Yes! Four, at school, you should always finish your work on time. Yes! Number five, at school, you should come to school prepared by bringing your school supplies and other things you need. Yes! Number six, at school, you should get to school late. No! Number seven, in the community, you should stand very close to other people. No! Number eight, in the community, you should wear a face mask. Yes! Number 9. In the community, you should wash and sanitize your hands. Yes! And number 10. You should help others when they are in need. Yes! Great job, kids! You did it! Now, isn't it fun to be responsible? I challenge you to do something responsible wherever you are after watching this video. Remember that with great power comes great responsibility. Well, boys and girls, that's all we have for character education today. I hope you learned a lot about being responsible. Please continue to stay responsible at home, in school, and around the community. Before we go, let's go ahead and sing our farewell song called Adventure Is Out There. 1, 2, 3. Adventure is out there, we'll learn and we share. Adventure is out there, we'll show that we care. Adventure is out there for me and for you. Adventure is out there, I hope to see you soon. Bye!
Welcome, my little Dikiki friends, to PBS University. It's Chamoru time! I'm Senora Loretta, and our Dikiki friend is...
Matingan!
Let's welcome our friends. Ready? A unu, a dos, a unu, dos, tres. Hop-a-day, friend! Today's lesson is on Tautau Comunidad, which means people in our community. Do you know any people in our community?
I know some people.
Okay, here are some people you may know in our community. The first Tautau Comunidad is the mayor. Mayor. And how we say that in Chamorro is Mahot. Matingan. Mahot. Can you share with our friends how to say Mahot?
Mahot, mahot, mahot.
Gov, mali. The second person in our Tautau Comunidad is police. Police. Policia. Policia. Let's try that.
Policia. Policia. Policia.
Ah, you said that very, very wonderful. The next person in our Tautau Comunidad is a firefighter. A firefighter. Yes, and that's a hose. Tautau Kimason. Tautau Kimason. Let's try that together.
Tautau Kimason. Tautau Kimason. Tautau Kimason.
Ah, wonderful. The next person in our Tautau Comunidad is doctor. Doctor. Medical. Medical. Like a telescope. Yeah. Medical. Let's try that.
Medical. Medical. Medical.
Ah, perfect. The next Tautau Comunidad is a little bit, I think you guys know this person, a little bit like jolly too. And that's the bus driver. Let's try that. Drive-in bus. Drive-in bus. That's a bus driver. Let's try saying that.
Drive-in bus. Drive-in bus. Drive-in bus.
Okay, perfect. This part, we're going to learn a little bit of adjectives that we could use simple sentences in Chamorro for our Tautau Comunidad. And these simple adjectives is smart. Smart. And how we say that in Chamorro is malati. Malati. Can you say that?
Malati. Malati.
Okay, let's use that with one of the Tautau Comunidad, like the mayor. Do you remember how to say mayor?
Mahot.
Oh, gov malik. So we're going to say malati e mahot.
Malati e mahot.
Good, Malik. The next adjective is fast. Sadik. Sadik. Let's try that.
Sadik. Sadik. Sadik.
Good, Malik. And so, boys and girls, we're going to use that in a simple sentence. Sadik. E. Policia. Sadik. E. Policia. Let's try that.
Sadik. E. Policia. Sadik. E. Policia.
All right. That was so wonderful. The next adjective is, funny. Natsalik. Natsalik. Let's try that.
Natsalik. Natsalik.
Oh, good job. And that means like very funny. So who do you think is so funny in our community?
Driban bus.
Oh, perfect. Let's try that in a simple sentence. Ready? Natsalik e driban bus.
Natsalik e driban bus.
Good, Malik. Loka. Loka. Loka means tall. Let's try that.
Loka. Loka. Loka.
What do you think loka means?
Tall.
Oh, good job. Tall. So we can say one of the Tato comunidad is short and the other is tall. Who should we use as a simple sentence?
We should use loka for Tato Kumisong.
Oh, okay, let's try that for Tato Kumisong. Ready? Loka e Tato Kumisong. Loka e Tato Kumisong. Let's try that.
Loka e Tao Tao Kumisan. Loka e Tao Tao Kumisan.
Good job. I'm so proud of you. And I'm so proud of you, boys and girls. Okay, Famaguan. That was our Tao Tao Kumunadad. Mahot. Policia. Tao Tao Kumisan. Medical. Driving bus. And don't forget our adjectives. Malati, Sadik, Natsalik, very funny, Loka, Estamakputsumoru, Natsafohamsu, Ajos!
Ajos!
Fast, fun facts! Fast, fun facts! With Mr. Ernest Pochoko.
Nyaweskano, Nyaweskano. That is one of the Native American greetings, and it literally translates to, I am thankful that you are well. Isn't that such a beautiful way to greet someone? Well, there is a reason why I'm using one of the Native American tongues to greet you today. It is because it is part of our Fast Fun Facts. We are going to discuss Niagara Falls, and I am Mr. Ernest Ochoco. Let's go on the journey together. So Niagara Falls borders two different countries. One is the United States of America and the other one is Canada. And there are three falls that actually make up all of the Niagara Falls. The first fall is on the American side. It is called the American Falls, such an original name. And the second falls that's also on the American side is called the Bridal Veil Falls. Dun, dun, ta dun, 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 ta dun, I'm getting married. And the third falls is called the Horseshoe Falls. At least that's how I think a horse sounds. And a majority of the Horseshoe Falls is actually on the Canada side. And about 700,000 gallons of water cascades down the falls per second. That is a lot of water, and that is a lot of seconds. Can you imagine? Wow, I don't have to imagine because I was actually there. I actually visited Niagara Falls with a good friend of mine, Miss Linda Frank, and we rode something called the Maid of the Mist, and we went into the falls, well, not into the falls, but near the falls, and it was one of the most beautiful sights I've ever seen. So thanks for sharing this fast, fun fact with me about Niagara Falls. Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.
Today, students, I'm Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenorio. For more than a year now, you all have continued to wash your hands and watch your distance from others, and you've done a really great job wearing your masks. We know your parents and guardians have helped you to make these changes to keep yourself and your community safe. As Governor Leon Guerrero said, we are happy you are here. We want you to continue to learn and sharpen your skills with the help of PBS University. This program is the result of a collaborative effort. We couldn't do it alone. I'd like to thank the teachers and support staff of the Guam Department of Education and PBS Guam for their work and their commitment to our students. I'd also like to thank you, students, for participating at home. To your parents, I'd like to thank you for taking an active role in your child's education. We are all eager to return to a time when all of us can share and study together in person. Until then, we hope you learned something new from this PBS University instruction.